cannot resist.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's seven heavens. I greet you all in the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. You happy to be here this morning?
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I know it's a little cold out there, but we are never cold. Amen.
Amen.
The people of God are never cold. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because we have some heat from within that keeps us warm. Amen.
Praise Amen.
We have the oil and we have the wine. Amen.
Amen.
We have a nice mix of it. Amen.
Amen.
Without the oil and the wine, we will not make it. Amen. Blessed be the name of the living God. I thank God for Sister Priscilla and the mother and the beautiful daughter and Brother Sylvester. Hallelujah. Thank Amen. God you're able to make it for prayer. Amen.
Amen.
Always thank God for my precious brother Gessner. Hallelujah. His dedication to fellowship. Hallelujah. And of course, we thank God for the mighty work he's doing with Brother Chris Van Aert. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord put in his heart to be in fellowship. And I believe before the foundation of this world, it was in his heart to use his talent to honor the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And so he seeks what you call fellowship of the saints. Hallelujah. And he knows that when the saints are gathered, you know, it's a time of joy. Amen.
Amen.
So when we come together, it's a time of joy. And I thank God my wife is able to make it because she walks every other Sunday. You know, we are in this world, you know, we are being tempted and tried and everything. Amen. You know, because remember that, you know, Pharaoh is still here. Amen.
Amen.
Pharaoh is still here. Amen. We will not depart from Pharaoh until we leave this body. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You know, if you read the scripture very well, Jesus told us, like we read last Sunday, he said, the word that I speak, it profits this flesh nothing. Amen.
Mm.
He said, but the word that I speak to you are life, their spirit and their life. Amen.
Amen.
But unto the flesh it profits nothing. Amen.
Amen.
But God still honors his word, even on the flesh.
That's right.
That's why we have miracles. Amen.
That's right.
Miracles are out of the norm. In other words, things that are not supposed to be. Amen.
Mm.
The same way when Joshua stood there and told the sun to stand still, that's a miracle.
Amen.
Because the sun is supposed to be moving, but he told him to stand still. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So same thing that the body that you and I have, which you know this body is filled with bacteria and viruses, and if you doubt what the body is doing, every day you wake up, you're getting older. Is that right?
Amen.
Yeah. You look at my mother, she didn't used to be this way. You look at our mama there too, she didn't used to be this way. You see the little girl being born, how little nice, but very soon, 10, 20 years, she started looking like Corinthia, like Paul, and before you know it, you know, we are aging. Amen? Why are we aging? Because the body has a timetable and a time stamp, an expiration date. Amen?
Amen.
Everybody has a day of expiring. Amen. You may not know it, but it's there. God stamped it.
Amen.
And when God stamped it, there's nothing else he can do.
Yes.
That's why the devil can have a buffet. Devil knows that. That's why the devil has a buffet on our body. Apostle Paul said, my body is a buffet. That's what he said. He said, devil is feasting on my body. He said that, you know, the pain was so much, the things I don't want to do are the things I do. He said many times even his back was filled with lashes as he's preaching the word of God. And then God keep telling him, Paul, my grace is sufficient for you. Amen. Because in your weakness, then I am strong. Amen. In your weakness, he is perfect. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
See, the word of God does not need any improvement.
That's right.
You cannot improve on the word of God.
True.
Because he's perfect.
Amen.
If you can improve on the word of God, then he's not omnipotent.
Right.
God is omnipotent. He's omniscient. He's everything you can ever think of. So you cannot improve his word.
Right.
When he speaks, it's done. It's nothing else you can do about it. Amen.
Amen.
So when he say, I will bless you, it is done.
Amen.
There's nothing the devil can do. He can buffet on the body. But we have received his blessing. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So this morning, before we go into the message, we have today's message will be the message of Thyatira. And we have to watch the time. So I'll give 5 minutes of quick testimony. And at 12, we start. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the week was wonderful. And Sister Priscilla said that, you know, she doesn't want to come out and say this. So I'm going to read what she sent to me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
She pleaded with me to please read this to the church. So it will be recorded on earth and in heaven. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because remember, every word that we speak here is recorded both in heaven and on earth. Amen. So she sent me this. This was Thursday, 8:30 p.m. And, you know, sometimes when you're looking for a word of encouragement, God will just drop it somehow. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, Thursday was another challenging day for myself. I go to work. I drive sometimes 3 hours to come home. I am tired. And I'll come here every day and I pray. I lay down on this place. I cry. And then I go home. And sometimes I get a text and I say, Lord, thank you.
Amen.
Because, you know, it's never easy. Even the little ministry God has given us, it's not easy.
Yes.
You know, if with man it cannot be done, but with God all things are possible.
Amen.
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 So Sister Priscilla wrote this, and Sister Priscilla is right here. You can focus the camera on half a second, so people will know who Sister Priscilla is. Amen. Because Sister Priscilla is right here, so you can see what she said to address the church. Hallelujah. As a foundation, she finished her pharmacy school, and she's trying to pass the board. Amen. That's to lay foundation. But she knows that with man, it's impossible. But with God, all things are possible.
Amen.
So she wrote, good evening, Brother Paul. This is Priscilla, Brother Sylvester's wife. And Brother Sylvester is here with us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As a gallant soldier. Hallelujah. Oh my. He said, I just wanted you to share my testimony with the rest of the congregation. I wrote the first part of my board exam on the 4th of November. It was very hard. In fact, I thought I had failed. I had 2 breaks during the 6-hour exams. I spent both breaks in the restroom crying. Amen? I'm praying to God that I needed a miracle.
Amen.
In fact, I went on my knee crying. It took 3 days for the results to be posted online. Pass mark was 75. I promise God, hallelujah,
mm-hmm.
I promise God I need 75 to pass. And I promise to give a testimony. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's what she's doing.
Yeah. Wonderful.
She's fulfilling her promise.
Right.
Praise God.
There were 10 lepers one day Jesus healed. And how many came back to give him thanks?
That's right.
He said, where is the rest of them?
That's right.
It was at that point he told that those that came, he said, now you are healed. So I wonder what happened to the rest that never came back.
Yes.
Huh? Yes. All right, now. You make God a promise, you have to keep it.
Mm.
Hallelujah. God doesn't need too much from us.
Amen, brother.
Doesn't need too much from us. And then my sister continued, God did it.
Wonderful.
Amen.
And I passed.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Give God a hand. With 78.
Amen.
Please share this with the church.
Hallelujah.
Hope it will be. Hope we'll be here on Sunday, and they are here.
Amen.
Thank you. God bless you. My regards to your wife. God bless you,
Amen.
My precious sister.
Amen.
See, God is in simplicity.
Amen. Yes, sir.
God is in simplicity.
That's right, brother.
If anyone tells you that God is no longer working,
yes,
just ignore them.
Yes.
You don't need to fuss. He doesn't need to argue.
Amen.
Here's another little testimony I will share with you for 2 seconds. You know, every testimony sometimes doesn't end the way we think.
Mm-hmm.
But yet, God wants to speak. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
God wants to speak.
Amen.
My wife has a job in New York with her company. I'm not going to call the name because, you know, it's on the internet. She worked for this company. And she finished working for a month, and they told her it takes 15 days to pay for the previous month. It's okay. So I did the invoice for my wife, and she supposedly sent the invoice to the company. We've been waiting for the payment. On Tuesday, I went to sleep. Friends, I'm saying it in the hearing of everyone. God talks to me through my dream.
Amen.
Since I was born.
Yeah.
Since I knew my name. God has been talking to me through my dream. since I knew my name. On Tuesday, God came to me. God showed me. The check you're expecting will be half. They will not pay the full check. In my dream, I saw the check. Half of the check. I wake up. My wife was laying next to me. I said, honey, the check you're expecting is going to be half. She goes, why? I said, that I can tell you. I just know it's going to be half. The check hasn't come yet. But when it comes, it's going to be half. They're going to subtract all kinds of hours. I don't know what happened, but that's the check I saw. My wife, you know, she said, let's cancel this. I said, honey, let's cancel it. So we pray to cancel it so that when we receive the check, you'll be full. Okay. Thursday, I came back from work. The same Thursday, my sister sent this testimony. I came back from work. I went to the mail. I opened the mail. The check came. It was half. Just like the Lord showed me. I kept the check because I didn't know what to do. My wife was still coming home. I said, I'm not going to call her and tell her because she may have an accident on the road. Because we needed this money, we waited. I said, I'm not going to call her. I'm going to wait until she comes home. And actually, I went, I hid the letter, so I'm not tempted to call her, you know. Because sometimes I will say, I won't do something and I'll do it, you know. So I just kept the letter, so I won't look at it until she comes back. So she came back and we went into the room quietly. I went into the closet where I hid it. I said, are you standing up? She goes, yeah, that's okay. Here, this letter I just came. And she opened, she said, this is it. I quit. I won't go back to that job again. I'm done. What is this? You know, I said, Lord, I know this is the result. I said, what is going on? My wife was so upset. And then finally, something led her to look at the source file that she sent to the company, which is the invoice I had given to her. It turns out she took her phone and she took a picture of the invoice and she only took the center of the invoice. Mm-hmm. So on the check, they wrote payment for November 18 to 25, which is 1 week. Mm-hmm. November 18 to 25, so they only paid 1 week for the whole month. But she forgot to include October. October 18 to 25. She forgot to include on the invoice I gave her from October 2 to 18, and she missed from October 25 to 31. So the company only paid for 1 week and got so kind on the check, they said, note, October 18 to 25, because that's what she sent.
Right.
So that's what they paid. So I said, there is the fault. God. So I said, okay, let's call the company. And she did and did everything, and we're hoping that tomorrow they claim they're going to rescind the whole payment. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God still speaks.
Amen.
God still speaks. God never departed from us. Some people think because God sent us a prophet, God doesn't do anything anymore. That's not in the Bible.
Exactly.
It's all about Jesus Christ.
Amen.
As a matter of fact, that verse or that phrase, it's all about Jesus Christ, has been on my heart all week. Mm. Maybe one day God will make it a message. And it's truly all about Jesus Christ. The message we receive is all about Jesus Christ. This whole Bible is all about Jesus Christ.
Amen.
From Genesis to Revelation, it's all about Jesus Christ. The prophet that we're sent, we're all about Jesus Christ. The seven church ages is all about Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The seals is all about Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The feast, the seven feasts is all about Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The sixfold message that was given to Daniel by Angel Gabriel is all about Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Everything is about him.
That's right.
And this is the problem we have, even in Christianity. They don't want it to be all about him.
Mm.
All we are learning about the church ages is to show you where Jesus Christ is subtracted.
Amen.
That's all the church ages is. Mm. The subtraction of Jesus Christ.
Mm.
They don't want him. Until now, he's no longer in at all. Mm. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If time will permit us, we go through a couple of this. From the Nicaea Council, which Israel have gathered about seven times, So all their arrangement and their ecumenical council and their argument is all about Jesus Christ.
Amen.
What shall we do with this Jesus Christ?
Amen.
Different doctrines and understandings about what shall we do with Jesus Christ? Mm. It's all recorded in history. Yes. But one thing about Christianity is not just history. It is a spirit.
Amen.
You see now? So when people talk about Christianity in a historical form, they are forgetting it is a spirit.
That's right.
Because the same spirit that began in the first church age is still working through.
That's right.
It might be changing form, but it's the same spirit.
Amen.
It may be changing the horse rider, but it's the same spirit.
Amen.
It can change from white to red to black to pale, but it is the same spirit.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the living God. Let's be on our feet. Hallelujah. So this morning, the message is Thyatira Church Age, which is the fourth church age. So when you open your Bible to Revelation chapter 2, it will begin from verse 18 to 29. So once you get it, we bow down our heads in prayer. And you ask the Lord to take over. Just lead us. When you get Revelation chapter 2 from verse 18, you hold it, and then you bow down our heads in prayer. Thank God for everything. My Lord. My God. El Shaddai,
hallelujah.
Most precious Lord,
yes,
it's all about you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
If man can just take themselves away,
yes,
if we can just let you have preeminence,
yes,
it's all about you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, we gather here this afternoon, Lord, to glorify your name.
Yes.
If we can just glorify your name,
yes,
if we can just speak about you, if we can just meditate on your name,
yeah,
you said victory will be ours.
Amen.
When in the first church age, Lord Jesus, that you moved in the face of a lion.
Yeah.
When we can even go all the way back to the first Exodus, Lord Jesus. When you were there,
yeah,
and you were moving with Joshua, Lord, there was a Jericho in front of them.
Yes.
And there they could speak to the walls of Jericho because they glorified your name. They marched around the wall 7 times and sang glory, hallelujah,
yes,
and the wall came crumbling down.
Yes.
And today, if we can cut the revelation,
yes,
it's all about Jesus Christ.
Yes.
All the 7 church age messengers,
yes,
they were sent by Jesus Christ.
Yes.
That the message himself is sent by Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Because you say, when we have already accepted those that you have sent, we have already accepted you.
Yes.
Because you are in your word.
Yes, Lord.
But the people want to say that God is in the church. That is, God is in his word.
Yes.
For his word can never be denominated.
You,
his word can never come back void. His word is amen and amen.
Amen.
And upon the infallible word of Jesus Christ, we come this afternoon.
Yes.
First, to thank you, my Lord, for our sister, yes, Priscilla.
Yes.
How you have guided her in her exams. How she knew the contempt for the faith,
yes,
that was delivered for the sent first.
Yes.
How she knew she had to cry out to you, Lord Jesus. Because if you can cry out to you, you will answer. When Moses was marching on in the first Exodus, there was the Red Sea. And Moses began to cry. And he said unto Moses, why do you cry? Speak to the rock. Speak to the rock. He said, take up your staff, Moses. Touch the Red Sea. And I will part for my people. When they were starving, Lord Jesus,
yes,
why do you cry? Speak to the rock.
Hallelujah.
And the rock will give its water. Hallelujah. You are the same rock that Sister Priscilla spoke to,
amen,
when she was taking that exam.
Yes,
and she come this afternoon,
yes,
to glorify your name.
Yes,
because her experience must be granted and thus saith the Lord. Therefore, I ask you, Lord Jesus, to rekindle the fire that's burning in her now, Lord Jesus. For you say, hot not the oil. Hot not the wine, because the oil is the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And the wine is the stimulation.
Amen.
It's the revelation of Jesus Christ. Let it burn in her heart every day, Lord Jesus, to understand that this journey you have started is just the beginning.
Amen.
And she will do greater things in her profession.
Hallelujah.
In her life as a,
hallelujah,
Christian. In her life as a mother.
Yes.
In her life as a daughter of her mother.
Yes.
In her life as a mother of her children. In her life as a wife of my precious brother,
yes,
Sylvester.
Yes.
She will do great exploits. Because she has dedicated her life. Because she said, I will come and glorify your name.
Yes.
I will come and testify of the glory of the living God.
Yes.
Is there anything impossible for you to do?
Yes.
My Lord, my God, we are here this afternoon.
Yes.
But I guess I need you, Lord Jesus.
Yes.
But I quit for I and family need,
yes,
you, Lord.
Yes.
I need you more than ever, Lord. My wife needs you more than ever, Lord. If you don't come, my Lord, my God, my mother needs you, Lord Jesus. My patron needs you, Lord Jesus. Everywhere the saints are gathered this afternoon, let the gathering be upon us here, the Lord. Let the cackers be there, Lord Jesus. That the eagles will feast, hallelujah. They have the fresh kill everywhere. That the saints be gathered this afternoon. For your name's sake, come and take preeminence. Take me away from this place. Come and speak, my Lord. If you just speak to us, Lord Jesus, it will be sufficient. As I yield my spirit, as I yield my soul, as I yield my body, come and take full control and speak, my Lord. For your name's sake, I ask with thanksgiving in my heart. In the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
And who had the eyes like unto a flame of fire. His feet like fine brass. Hallelujah. I'm going to continue reading. But I'm telling you something here, right there on verse 18. There's always a great controversy what Jesus Christ looked like. Man in their thought, brother, have painted all kinds of image about Jesus Christ. Do you see what Jesus said of himself here? You see his eyes? What else do you need to know? What else do you need to know? That's why I don't believe in any picture, brothers. I don't care how good he looks. I don't hang them.
Yes.
I cannot hang anything that you call God.
Amen.
Jesus is telling you here.
Yes.
Look at his eyes. A flame of fire.
Mm.
That's who Jesus is. Look at his feet. Fine brass. Painting all kinds of pictures from Rome. Every day a man is worshiping them. I won't. Look, let's continue here. I know thy works.
Mm.
And your charity. Mm. And your service. And your faith and thy patience, that thy works and the last to be more than the first. Hallelujah. All these are nuggets, and the prophets will help us to understand them as time will lead us, because there are so many things going on here. There are two works here being identified, the first work and the second work. He said the last is even more than the first. Hallelujah. And then the charity, and in between there you have service, you have faith, and you have patience, and you have works. Because what? Because our faith is worked by what? You know, James wrote it, the trial of our faith will work out what? Perfection, but it has to be tried. And then once the faith is worked out, you have patience, hallelujah. So the prophet said it's well fitted here, hallelujah. So, but on 20 he said, notwithstanding, I have a few things against thee. Oh my. Because thou sufferest that woman, Jezebel, who called herself a prophetess, to teach, to seduce my servants, to commit fornication, to eat things sacrificed unto idols. This is serious here. Mark that. Jezebel's spirit. Mark it. Hallelujah. We shall get to it again. And I gave her space to repent of her fornication, that she did not repent. Behold, I will cast her into a bed, and then that commit adultery with her. See, this woman, her people committing adultery with her. And he has going to give them what? A great tribulation. Now, you doubting God, we have tribulation coming? Tribulation is coming. Except they repent of their deeds. But now, I will kill her children with death. He's talking about killing them with death. Isn't everybody dying? So which death is he talking about here? Doesn't every flesh die? But this is another death he's talking about. He's not talking about death of the body here. Because the Bible cannot make mistake. Everybody's dying. But these particular people are going to have death. That's a death we're talking about here. That's the second death in the book of Revelation also. But let's continue. And the churches shall know that I am he which searches the reins and the heart. And I will give unto every one of you according to your works. But unto you, I say, and unto the rest in Thyatira, as many as have not this doctrine, which have not known the depth of Satan, And as they speak, I will put upon you none other burden, no more burden to be given to you, but that which you have already hold fast till I come. And he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power over the nation, and he shall rule them with a rod of iron, and the vessel of potter shall they be broken to shivers, even as I received of my Father, and I will give unto him the morning star. The morning star is Jesus Christ. It's all about Jesus Christ. He's still the same gift to every church age. He will give him the morning star. And he that have an ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying unto the churches. Amen. You may have your seats. You know, again, when I speak or preach, I do get excited, and I want to do this like teaching at the same time, because we have so many things I want to touch by the grace of God, the Church Age of Thyatira. Now, we salute, of course, the Church Age of Thyatira. Hallelujah. And the Thyatira Church Age lasted the longest of all the church ages. Amen. This church age lasted about 900 years. It started from 606 AD to 1520 AD. This church age started from around 606 AD to 1520 AD. Amen? Now, what we are getting here is that God is trying to tell us something that he's using to rebuke this church age. We have so many things to touch, but the first and foremost is this Jezebel that we talked about. Jezebel is married to Ahab, which all of you know. But Ahab married Jezebel not for spiritual reason, but political reason. Which is why when Jezebel came into the kingdom, that Ahab was the king, she brought in her own god, which is Baal. She brought in Baal, which is her god. Now, for you to understand, Jezebel being a Gentile, she's also, I call it, a type also of the spirit of Delilah. Because Jezebel's goal here is not to come into Israel and unite with the people of Israel and serve the God of Israel. Pay attention to this, because we are all Gentile. So we are not against Jezebel just because she's a Gentile. All of us are Gentiles. We shall see in the history of the scripture where Gentiles are called in. The true Gentile, a type of the church, when they come in, they will worship the God of Abraham. But when Jezebel came in, she was not coming in to worship the God of Abraham. She has a motive, which is why the fourth church age is a total deviation. When we talked about the church age of Pergamos last two Sunday, which is the third church age, understand that the church age of Pergamos, they were following a different doctrine of Balaam. But the doctrine of Balaam did not come to abolish the doctrine of the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. The doctrine of Balaam came to mix up. It's about mixing up. He was telling the people of Israel, you know, Moabites are your brothers and sisters. We can eat the same food. You can do the same thing. You can marry their children. God said, don't marry them, don't worry about that. They are brothers and sisters. You can mix up, it's all okay. That's the doctrine of Balaam. But the doctrine of Jezebel is not to mix up. It is to abolish. It's to do away with. That's what Jezebel came to do. It's to do away with, to cut out. Forget the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I have another God for you. Balaam didn't say that. As a matter of fact, the prophet said that Balaam was worshiping the same God, but he never received the pillar of fire. Right. They sacrificed the same way. They killed seven bullocks. They killed seven rams. Because you understand that the people of Moab are related to Abraham. Mm-hmm. Because they came from Lot. Right. The people of Moab are the children of Lot. Lot begat them from the daughter. Right. You see now? So they were able to relate to the God of Abraham. Mm-hmm. But Jezebel, being a total Gentile, came with a different motive to seduce the people, to introduce another God, to have our own prophetess, like the Bible said. And God said, I hate it so much. And God said, I'm going to burn them. And God said, I'm going to bring tribulation. I'm going to kill her and her children. And later God said, he's talking about a church. God said, I will kill that church. Did you see that? We read it. It's right there. Where it says that right there on the Revelation 2:29, he that have an ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. And then he also repeated it to us on 2:23, Revelation 2:23, and I will kill her children with death and all the churches. Right. It's right there. Right. So you can't just say what Abraham says, it's right there in the scripture. Mm. It's not hidden. We just said, thank God for giving us a prophet that was able to expatiate and bring this thing to light. Amen. You see now, the word revelation is to reveal, is to unveil, yes, to take away what is hidden. Amen. For you to see. Amen. It's not to manufacture something new. It is there, but you just didn't see it.
Amen.
Because when John got to heaven, and John was looking for who can even open the book, John was told nobody's worthy, not in heaven, not on earth, to even open the book or look inside. And John wept. But the scripture told us that the lamb was slain before the foundation of the earth. And John was told, weep no more, for the lion from the tribe of Judah have prevailed.
Amen.
And when John looked to see the lion, he saw a bleeding lamb.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when you continue on Revelation chapter 10, down further, you will see that John was told, take the book.
Amen.
Eat the book.
Amen.
It shall be sweeter than honey in your mouth, but bitter in your belly.
Amen.
But the book was sealed with seven seals.
Amen.
And John began to write. But when he got to the seven seals, he said, don't write it. Amen. And then when you go to the book of Daniel, Daniel also received the same inspiration. He received similar vision. And Daniel wanted to know the end time. Daniel was told, Daniel, go and rest. I have a grave for you. And I have people that are coming. Stand in your lot. On the day of resurrection, you will stand in your lot. But for now, Daniel is not given to you. And then Gabriel gave him sixfold message. We can get to some of them, time permitting. Knowing that it's all about the fulfillment of what Jesus has done. Amen?
Right.
So continuing on this doctrine. Now, understand Jezebel. When you think Jezebel, think about what happened to Samson. Samson is also a type of a church.
Amen.
Samson is a church that's anointed.
Amen.
Samson is the bride that's called.
Amen.
He was a child of promise. But because he listened to another God, that came from Delilah. His parents told him, don't do this. But he insisted. Because there was something seducing him. It's the same seduction we see here. That Jezebel has the seducing spirit. And Samson was seduced. And when Samson was seduced, the result of it, you know the story? He lost his eyes. What does the eye of Samson mean to a Christian? It's revelation. The eye means revelation.
Amen.
So now Samson is standing there helpless.
Right.
He knew nothing anymore. You see now, he forgot who he was.
Amen.
He was a man that took a jawbone and killed 1,000 in one day.
Amen.
He was a man that went on top of the mountain and they put a gate around him. He took the gate, put it on his shoulder, walked down the hills.
Amen.
But now he has no eyes, he cannot see. And the prophet said, what a pitiful sight for a church to come to that stage. He said, now the daughters of Philistines, they came around. They said, so are you Samson? So that is you. They can make a mockery, they can cuss him, they can slap him. You don't even know who slapped him. That is the condition of a church, my people. We don't want to be in that condition.
Amen.
When Samson realized who he was, he cried, Abba Father.
Yes, sir.
He cried for the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Amen.
And he said, one more time that I can avenge these Philistines. And God answered him, hallelujah.
Amen.
That was what happened in the same spirit of Jezebel. But let's compare this to other Gentiles, women. Because, you know, the prophet sometimes, people say he's a woman hater. They say that William Graham hates women because of the way he talks about women. If you listen to the message, you may come up with the same conclusion. But William Graham said, if he hates women, it means that other prophets before him hates women.
Mm.
Because this Jezebel, Elijah told her, dog will eat your meat. The same Jezebel. Dog will eat your meat. She brought idolatry in the house of Israel. She caused the people to worship Baal. It's a type of a church, hallelujah. But there were Gentile women that we can relate to. People like Rahab, despite her condition. I know the Bible said to us, she's an ill-famed woman. She was a woman that was selling her body. And the prophet also told us that he believed that Jezebel was selling her body because of the love she had for her father by a real God. And she said to them, I know your God.
Amen.
I know if you guys come here, Jericho, we stand no ground. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And She was such a gifted woman that she was accounted for in the scripture. Hallelujah. She married Salmon, which you know. And Salmon begat Boaz. And look, once you connect Boaz, you go to another Gentile woman. You see how they're connecting to one another? Once you connect Rahab, you're connecting right there, Ruth. Amen. Because Boaz was begotten by Salmon. Salmon was married to Rahab. Amen. Now, you go to Ruth, a Moabite, which we have read how that Balaam doctrine was based on Moab. The same God now sent Naomi to go because of hunger to Moab. And there you know the history and story how that Naomi lost everything. But there was a Gentile woman, a type of a church. So I'm giving you the type of churches for you to see which church do I belong to, which is my church. You gotta have something. The prophet said you must be born into it. It must be you. Amen. So here is Ruth. She declared and proclaimed unto Naomi, where you go, I will go.
Amen.
Your God will be my God.
Amen.
She didn't have a Jezebel spirit.
Amen.
She was not bringing the God of Moab to Israel.
Amen.
She declared unto Naomi, your God will be my God.
Amen.
Your people will be my people.
Yes.
The Gentiles are grafted in.
Amen.
As a grafted Gentile, we are wild by nature.
Amen.
The nature of Gentiles are wild.
Amen,
despite the fact that all are born in sin, shaped in iniquity,
Amen.
Came to this world speaking life, but the Gentiles are wild in nature.
Amen.
Our customs are wild. Our tradition is wild. That's why you can ask, can anything good come out of these Gentiles?
Wow.
But throughout the church ages, that has been the battle between the tradition of the Gentiles and accepting Jesus Christ
Amen.
As our Savior and Messiah
Amen.
And the Godhead himself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But here, Ruth was very simple. That's why it was accounted unto her in the scripture. Ruth being called, Ruth walking, Ruth being paid, Ruth waiting. Hallelujah. Just like the Gentiles, we have been called. We have been washed. Then we are waiting to go home. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because there's yet to be another going away.
Yes.
In the first Exodus, it was an exodus, a movement of the people from a land to another land.
Amen.
It was a movement from Egypt unto Palestine.
Mm-hmm.
Because God made a promise unto Abraham.
Mm-hmm.
He said, I will bless you, Abraham. I will bless your children.
Amen.
We shall get to that temple meeting because that promise is a type of the promise that Jesus Christ came to fulfill.
Amen.
Because that promise of covenant was a covenant God made with Abraham.
Amen.
But Abraham was a beneficiary.
Amen.
Because God made a covenant with himself.
Amen.
He could not make a covenant with a man.
Amen.
Because a man will fail.
That's yes. Right.
When it was time for the covenant, God put Abraham to sleep. His name was Abraham at the time. As we shall see in the book of Genesis, he put him to sleep. And God came down like a tunnel of fire and went through the sacrifice. And Abraham was not there. He was sleeping. Because by culture, when you're making a covenant, when you kill the animal, you split it in two. I will walk through the animal and you will walk through it too. Meaning, if I do not do what the covenant says, let me be the life of this animal, let me be dead. So Abraham has walked through the dead animal that God told him to kill. And he was waiting for God. God said, Abraham, you can see me. You can see me. Put him to sleep. If God made a covenant with Abraham, Abraham failed God. Because he went into Hagar to produce Ishmael. That was not the promise. He didn't have the patience. He listened to Sarah. You see now? So if that was a promise and a covenant between God and Abraham, God will kill Abraham.
Mm-hmm.
But because God had made a covenant with himself,
Amen.
And Abraham is beneficiary.
Mm-hmm.
The same way God came down himself.
Wonderful.
1 Timothy 3:16. He came down himself
mm-hmm.
with no controversy.
Hallelujah.
But throughout history, there's controversy.
Oh.
Did he come down Was he just a son that come down? Did he have a mother somewhere? Do we go through the mother in order to get to him? We shall get to some of these things. That's the Thyatira church age. That is the hardcore of the church age. Who is Jesus Christ? Who shall we go to? We don't need him anymore. Let's have another God. This emperor, this Jesus, we can't see him. Let's make some images. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But this roots, a type of a true church. Hallelujah. That's always been the issue of who is the mediator. Like I just said a minute ago. Who is the mediator between man and God? So now, again, we're talking about the church age. All these things, some of them are historical, but they are also here with us. Because every church you're talking about, most of them are still here today. You know that Catholicism was the beginning of denomination. It's in history.
Right.
Catholicism is the beginning of denomination. It's in history. There's no dispute about this. You can go to Google, you can Google it, you can go to, it's all over, it's all over. You can't just say William Branham said it, it's all over the internet as well. The issue is, who is the mediator between man and God? So Catholicism said, well, we have Pope. Pope is the mediator, the in-between. Between Christ and man, M-E-N. And he, man, Pope, man, is now standing in between Christ and man. But the scripture says contrary, that there's only one mediator between man and God.
Amen.
Is that right? It's in 1 Timothy 2:5. 1 Timothy 2:5, he said, for there is one God, one mediator between God and man. 1 Timothy 2:5. There's one God, only one mediator. There's not two. Mm-hmm. Between God and man, which is everyone.
Amen.
Inclusive. Now, the same doctrine is trying to tell us that, you know, God has a mother. You know, before you even get to Jesus, you gotta talk to the mother of God. Because God has a mother. Is that right? Yes. And the mother of God happened to who? Mary? Really? Let's go to Acts of the Apostle. Because the scripture will give us the answer. Let's go to Acts chapter 1 from verse 10 to 14. Let's see where Mary is after Jesus departed. The scripture will give us the answer.
Right.
Hallelujah. All these are part of the Thyatira church age. We are laying foundation. Glory.
Hallelujah.
He said, and while they looked steadfast towards heaven, as he went up, only he, not his mother, him, two men stood by them in a white apparel, which also said, ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? The same Jesus, which is taken up into heaven, shall also come down in the same like manner as you have seen him go into heaven. Then returned they unto Jerusalem from Mount called Olivet, which is from Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey. And when they come in, they went up into the upper room where abode, who was there? Peter, James, John, Andrew, Philip, Thomas, Bartholomew, Matthew, James the son of Alphaeus, Simon Zealot, Judas the brother of James. These all continued with one accord in prayer and supplication with the woman, Mary, the mother of Jesus. Mary, the mother of Jesus, is there, waiting in the upper room to do what? To receive the Holy Ghost. How can she be waiting in the upper room with the disciples and you're telling me that you have to go through her to get to Jesus? She's waiting like anybody else to receive the Holy Ghost. Let's see what happened there. And when, let's continue in Acts chapter 2, drop it to 2, continue. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. See, all of them. Okay? And suddenly there came a sound from heaven, as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them glove tongue like a fire, and it sat upon each of them. And they were all now, they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. And they began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit will give them utterance. Hallelujah. And then you can read on and on and on. I would like you to read it at your own time too, because of time. Because there are good stuff there. As they began to speak in tongue, you know what tongue means now? Because the tongue we're talking about is languages. They listed tons of languages here. And when the men were speaking, everyone can hear them in their own language. Amen? That's what tongue means.
Exactly.
Tongue is not saying wabba, 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 whatever. That's making noise. It's called noise. Tongue is to speak. That's an interpreter. Amen? And the reason why the tongue was given here, you can see, is because everybody needs to know from their own language. Brothers and sisters, you know, all this doctrine out there flying around, you need to speak a language that only the Holy Ghost can understand. Which language is that? Really? You need to speak a language only the Spirit on which? Really? A language of man? Or because you can open your lips? I ask you a question. Doesn't the dumb worship God? Those who cannot speak at all, can the Holy Ghost hear them? You see, men twist small doctrine. Truly you can have the gift of prophecy. Truly you can have the gift of tongue. But somebody has to interpret it.
Amen.
If nobody can interpret it, you're making noise, Apostle Paul said. You rather just shut up. Because you're causing confusion.
Amen.
You say something that nobody knows what you're saying.
Amen.
You cannot. God is not the author of confusion. You know what? I'm pressured to read this. Let me read the languages so you can see. It's not just me talking here. Look, on 2:8, it says, and now we hear, on Acts 2:8, and how we hear every man in our own tongue where we were born. You say now they start talking about languages. Parthians, Medes, Elamites, dwellers in Mesopotamia, Judea, Cappadocia, Pontus, Asia, Phrygia, Pamphylia, Egypt, parts of Libya, Syrian, Rome, Prophetess, Crete, Arabian. We do hear them speak in our own tongue the wonderful works of God. Hallelujah. In their own language. The wonderful works of God. Hallelujah. This is the Pentecostal experience. It is the same today, hallelujah, the true Pentecostal experience. And I put here my note, Pentecost is an experience, which you know, it's not a denomination. We've got to go back to the original Pentecostal experience. God will not change. God will not improve. He is perfect, hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He cannot change, he cannot improve, hallelujah. Now, I told you of the covenant that God made with himself and Abraham, his beneficiary. That's on Genesis 15, and time is pressing, so I can't read everything. You can read that on Genesis 15 from verse 1. You can read the covenant, and you can see how God put Abraham to sleep and came and walked through himself. That's Genesis 15 from 1 to 21. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But see, I'm saying here about the promises of the first Exodus, which you know, I told you, is a movement from Egypt to Palestine. But the second Exodus is another movement. Hallelujah. The second Exodus happened on the day of Pentecost. The second Exodus happened on the day of Pentecost. It's a movement of the Holy Ghost to indwell a man. God came down from heaven as a Holy Ghost. Because Jesus said, soon, this world will not see me. But you will see me. Because I'll be in you. So who is the Holy Ghost? Jesus Christ. Because he said, I'm coming. He's the one that came. See now, and Saul, when he thought he was doing something for God on the way to Damascus, he knew that Jesus Christ, he didn't know who Jesus was, but he knew Jehovah.
Amen.
He knew pillar of fire.
Amen.
It's written in the Torah.
Mm-hmm.
He could read the Torah.
Yes.
He was learned under Gamaliel.
Amen.
The biggest teacher of his day, Saul, learned under Gamaliel. He knew the Torah very well. He thought he was doing God a favor. He knew the pillar of fire is Jehovah. So on the way to Damascus, he thought he was doing God a favor. And Jesus appeared unto him. Like what? Pillar of fire.
Amen.
And that's why it was easy for him to say, who are you? Because I'm thinking this is Jehovah. He said, I am Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So he was able to connect it. That Jehovah of the Old Testament
right.
is Jesus Christ of the New Testament.
Amen. Amen.
He was able to connect it. And that's why he can stand before King Agrippa. And he can declare, say, I don't come to you in the excellency of my knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
He said, but I come to testify of Jesus Christ crucified.
Amen.
Because I met him.
Amen.
He was a personal experience now.
Amen.
When he becomes personal to you, nothing can take it out of you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Nothing.
Hallelujah.
Glory. So that was the second Exodus. But yet, there's the third Exodus we're waiting for.
Yes.
What is the third Exodus?
Amen.
We are going to defy gravity.
Yes, sir.
The third Exodus is the rapture.
Amen.
It's a movement from this earth going up the sky.
Amen.
To meet him up in the air.
Amen.
That is the third testament, the third Exodus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's the movement of the people. Because now the Holy Ghost, which is God himself, which is the Spirit of God himself,
Amen.
Is indwelling in man.
Amen.
He's here to stay.
Amen.
The Holy Ghost, when he comes, is here to stay yes. in a believer.
Yes.
Why? Ephesians 4:30 tells you that. Grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, for which you are sealed.
Yes.
A sealed material is covered. It's sealed. There's nothing you can do. It's sealed.
Yes.
You are sealed.
Yes.
When the Holy Ghost comes into you, he's there to stay.
Amen.
He's not there temporary. He's not there for a part time. He's not there, the prophet said, from one revival to the other. He's there permanently. Grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, for which you are sealed until the day of your redemption.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Which means when he comes to stay. Permanent, hallelujah. And that Holy Ghost will recognize that when the voice calls from heaven, when Jesus is coming down on the sky, when the trumpet shall sound, the dead in Christ shall rise, we that are alive will not prevent them, hallelujah. But we must be changed according to 1 Thessalonians in the twinkle of an eye. That is rapture right there. We're going to be changed, brothers and sisters. Oh, it gives me joy to know that one day I will give up this body. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It gives me joy to know that one day I am coming up to meet him. Hallelujah. It just helps me to keep going. Hallelujah. Does it excite you?
Amen.
It excites me. That's the third Exodus. It's coming. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because the Spirit knows the Spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why Jesus said, on that day, I will tell them to walk away from me. Workers of iniquity, I don't know you. Because the Spirit was not in them. If his Spirit is in you today, the same Spirit that was in Christ in you, it will quicken your mortal vessel.
Amen.
The same
Amen.
Spirit is a
Amen.
Quickening Spirit.
Amen.
See now, so it's not just by manifestation of the gift, because many people mention on gift manifestation. The nine gift. Once they manifest the gift, they're good. No, it is at manifesting the life of the gift.
Amen.
There's also nine life of the Spirit to manifest, not just nine gift of the Spirit. Hallelujah. You have to manifest the life that's in Christ.
Amen.
That's what a Christian means.
Amen.
Not just somebody who has gift. Anybody can have gift.
True.
Gift and calling out with their repentance.
Amen.
From where we came from, Africa, oh, people have gift there. There are people that can walk through this wall. They're not even Christians. I'm telling you, they walk like light. They're not Christians. There are people that can jump over this building. They never entered the church. He was not there. He disappeared. He came home. He said, I'll come back, don't worry. And when he finished, he came back. He appeared again. And they said, you might as well go home. Because we can't lock the door. I mean, you might as well just go home. Oh yeah, there are people that, you know, you from Haiti, brother, you come on now. People turn into goats and all kinds of stuff, you know. These are gifts. They are without repentance. See, the rain, when it comes down, it's upon everything, right? When you go to the field and the rain is pouring down, you're a farmer. What do you see in your field? Everything there is growing.
Yeah.
Both what you planted and what you didn't plant. When the rain comes, you're just nourishing. Hallelujah. So you have the former rain. But we also have the later rain. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We shall talk some of this. Time is rushing. Because in the book of Joel chapter 2, he said, I will restore. We are living at the day of restoration of everything.
Amen.
We have received every restoration,
Amen.
Including the revelation of who Jesus is.
Amen.
So we're not confused anymore. Because God said, I will restore.
Amen.
What the palm worms ate. What the locust ate.
Yes.
What the caterpillar ate.
Amen.
What the cankerworms ate. He said, I will restore.
Amen.
They ate everything. Is that right?
Amen.
The palm worm came, he started eating the fruit of the tree.
That's right.
fruit of the tree is eaten, that means a Christian cannot bear fruit no more. And after that, here come the locusts to eat the leaves. The leaves is fellowship.
Amen.
You see now? And after that, they began to eat the bark of the tree, which is where the life of the tree is.
Yes.
And when the cankerworms is the one eating the bark of the tree. The prophet told us the bark of the tree is sound doctrine. Sound doctrine.
Amen.
That is, thus saith the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And after he's eaten, then what's left? Caterpillar just finished the root. And that's what you're facing today. When the root is taken off, you have idol worshiping. Because sound doctrine is taken out. So you no longer have itchy ears now. You know, you have the state and religion mixing to be one. You see now, that's what happened in the Pergamos church age. You see now, they mixed to be one. Because there, the Nicolaitan spirit, who was just a thought in the first church age of Ephesus, when in the third church age of Pergamos, it becomes a deed, a doctrine, combined with Bela. Hallelujah. Now you come to the fourth church age now, what do you have? Idol worshiping. Because the root has been taken off. There's nothing left. But the Lord said, I will restore, saith the Lord.
Glory.
And this is the day of full restoration. Hallelujah. We are not living in the age of reformation. It's a restoration of everything you can think of. The true Pentecost is restored. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Jesus is revealed. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
He has been hidden from all the church ages. We shall see some of the councils. Hallelujah. Let's move. Because I tell you, the revelation of Jesus Christ, look at the Nicaea councils. There are seven of them. I have little notes here and there. They're all over the internet. The first Nicaea Council happened on 325.
Right.
It was Emperor Constantine I that held it. What is the topic? They want to discuss something they call Arianism. Arianism. The Arianism they're discussing is they're saying, the doctrine of Arianism is saying that Jesus Christ is not God. He has a beginning. Arianism is saying that Jesus, because he was Son of God, had a beginning when he was born. So he couldn't be everlasting. He couldn't have existed before he was born.
Yeah.
They want to argue this. It was in the first Nicaea Council.
Right.
Hallelujah. And the second Nicaea Council was 381. They also discussed the same Arianism. There are so many isms here, my brothers and sisters. Apollianism and Sabellianism. I have some of the definition for those that want to have a knowledge acquirement. But make sure the knowledge is acquired for you to be more in Christ. Hallelujah. We're not just seeking knowledge for knowledge's sake. The knowledge is to give you more revelation of who Jesus is.
Amen.
So you can be more in fellowship. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Not stay away, but be more.
Amen.
And the next council was the Council of Ephesus. Happened in 431. Even the dates are there, from June 22 to July 31. This was Emperor Theodosius II. And there again, they discussed Nestorianism and Teocosa, and what they call Teocosa, and Paganism. We'll get to some of the definition in a second. The fourth one was the Council of Chalcedon. That's 451. They also have topics to discuss. And then you have the second Council of Constantinople. Happened in 553. And the third Council of Constantinople, 680 to 681. And then the second Council of Nicaea, 787. See, history cannot lie.
Amen.
That's why when the prophet was preaching this, he didn't have all the ammunitions we have today. He didn't have the internet. He just had Jesus trying to reveal these things to him. And the little books and there he read, like he said. Of course, he did some reading to see what is out there. What has history recorded? Now, Arianism, I told you, is the concept that believes that Jesus Christ is just the Son. He was begotten of the Father, but he had a point when he began. That's what they're saying. So he could not be a supreme deity. That's what they want to discuss. That's what they agreed upon. And the next one there was the Apollianism. Apollianism is the same proposed by that Jesus Christ could not have had a human mind. So Apollianism says that Jesus doesn't have a human mind. Rather, it was just a body. And the lower soul. And then they have the doctrine of Trinity, which you know. And monophysism. And so on and so forth. There's so many of these things. So why am I bringing this history? It's to bring to your knowledge that the message is true. The doctrine of the Thyatirian church age was based on all these council decisions. It's about dethroning Jesus Christ. It's about the doctrine of Jezebel introducing yet a different God. Because since man is this confused, they might as well introduce a different God that can understand. All these councils is to argue about this. Monotheism. You know, even the doctrine of pictures, like you know, they call it iconialism. Actually, the true word of it is Benzetine iconialism. What is that? It's the idea that they introduce icons, images, pictures to represent deity. That's why I have all these pictures of Jesus and Mary and whatever picture they want to have. Where did they take a picture of Mary? Where was Jesus' picture taken? Where is the camera? Was camera manufactured then? Men drew arts and all these saints, and they canonized them. I was watching something on YouTube the other day when they came and they were destroying some Catholic churches, I believe in the Philippines. And they showed it, soldiers came in, and they showed altar of Mary, where they have an image like a doll, sitting there. And the men were so mad, they were Muslims, they took it down, they cut it in pieces. It was nothing but a piece of cloth and everything inside. And they decorated everything and put it in an altar, and people come and bow down and put flour. What is that? You think that all this is a history? It's still happening today. People wake up and bow down before those things. They carry them around. This is their God. It's not just history. It's modern events. It's happening today. Hallelujah. Amen. Now, when you go to the Jewish feast, what do you see in the feast? The same Jesus Christ. The feast of Passover. The unleavened bread. The first fruit. The Pentecost. Hallelujah. These four feasts have all happened.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Do you know that? Do you know that we have the feast of Passover already? Of course you know.
Amen.
Jesus fulfilled that.
Amen.
When he was here, the unleavened bread, his body,
Amen.
Given as a sacrifice. The first fruit, his resurrection. Hallelujah. Pentecost. It happened on the day of Pentecost. We read it in Acts of the Apostle. But yet, we are waiting for other feasts. The feast of trumpets. Hallelujah. What will happen on the feast of trumpet? Hallelujah. On the feast of trumpet, two things are going to happen. Hallelujah. On the feast of trumpet, we are going to rapture. And the prophet said that trumpet always calls the Jews into action.
Right.
Hallelujah. So when the trumpet is blowing, we are going up. And the Jews will be getting introduction to Jesus. The trumpet will call them to come together for some lesson about who Jesus is.
Amen.
While we are going up, because we will not be here when they get to know. Just like Joseph being introduced to his brothers. And Joseph being introduced to his brother told the wife, honey, you can go in the back. We are the wife of Christ. So the wife of Joseph was not there when the brothers of Joseph was introducing themselves, when Joseph unveiled himself.
Amen.
He told the wife, step aside so I can cry before my people.
Amen.
So Jesus will come and cry before his people, say, I am he. You've been expecting me. I was the one you killed. Look at my palm. Look, it's me. I was the Messiah you're looking for. Today, there are many Messianic Jews, which you know, it's all over the internet, YouTube. One of them, my wife and I look at every now and then. You know, he has a very good YouTube channel, you know. He's a Messianic Jew. Yeah, many of them, they believe in the Messiah has come, but many don't. That's why there's 144,000 that were written in the book of Revelation that will get to know who he is. But we're not going to be here. Because the rapture is just between the husband and the wife.
Amen.
Amen. The rapture is just between the husband and the wife. Amen. That's between us. Amen. Because we are the wife
Amen.
Of Jesus.
Amen.
The bride of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He took a Gentile bride. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, I come for my own and my own received me not.
Amen.
So I moved out and took a Gentile's bride. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that's who we are. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you happy about that?
Amen.
But on the feast of the trumpet, it shall call the Jews into action for them to know this is who he is. And he said he's going to bring his two prophets to preach to them again. Moses and Elijah will preach back to them.
Amen.
Because the Jews, they believe in these two ministries so well.
Amen.
Moses and Elijah. That's why on Mount Transfiguration, they showed up. Moses and Elijah was there.
Amen.
And Peter, James, and John saw them.
Right.
You see now, there were no pictures. Hallelujah. There were no pictures. But when you see them, you know. Hallelujah. I don't need a picture. When I see them, I know who they are. When I get to heaven.
Amen.
Right? Because they know me and I know them.
Amen.
And you know them because they are in you. It's the same spirit. Amen.
Sorry.
See, nobody told Peter. Peter just said, Master, if it's okay, let's build three temples. One for you, one for Moses, one for Elijah. Jesus didn't say to them, listen, this is James. No. They just knew. And the voice said to Peter, you know, he said, hear ye him. One voice. This is my beloved son, whom I'm well pleased. Hear ye him. One voice. But the prophet told us that Peter had, you know, the spirit of denomination. Let's be three churches. Denomination. Mm-hmm. But Jesus, he was rebuked. He said, we only need one. One voice.
Amen.
One Christ.
Amen.
One Messiah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh, glory. So, those feasts, all of them is talking about Jesus. Everything is talking about Jesus. And then there will be atonement. Because then they will know, after they've been introduced to him, then they will mourn. They will cry, like Zechariah wrote.
Amen.
They will mourn him that they have pierced.
Right.
They will atone for what they have done.
Mm.
And then the tabernacle, hallelujah. The new Jerusalem coming down, hallelujah. Then they can join us, because in the Feast of Tabernacle they will join us, hallelujah. That's when we're going to be here for millennium, hallelujah.
Amen.
You know we're going to be here for millennium? Oh my. Don't worry yourself. Things are good. Hallelujah. Don't you love the Lord?
Amen.
I love the Lord. Hallelujah. We're doing good at times. So, but Abraham here. But Abraham began to tell us something in Tataria Church Age. He said online 2000. Son, if you want to follow, I have a couple of quotes. Time permitting. So historically, the city of Tataria was the least noteworthy. It's line 2000 on the Church Age book. He said it was situated on the confines of Mercia and Ionia. It was from this city, that Lydia, the seller of purple, came. She was Apostle Paul's first European convert, this Lydia in question. Hallelujah. On line 214, he said, now, the reason that the Spirit chose this city was for one reason. It was the major religion of Tartaria was the worship of Apollo. It was Apollo worshiping. Which is Trimanius, which was joined with the emperor worshipping cult. Apollo was the sun god, and next in power to the father Zeus. Again, it's idol worshipping, which you know, that's why it's a type of Jezebel. Hallelujah. He was known as the avatar of evil. You know, when I read this, I was interesting, because there's a movie out there called Avatar, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, people watch this thing, don't know where they came from. Avatar of evil.
Wow.
See now? Avatar of evil.
Mm-hmm.
Be careful what you watch. We don't want to go deep into certain things, but be careful out there, because the internet is crazy. The world is crazy as already, as you know it.
Mm-hmm.
You know the symbol, you see apple? You know apple symbol? You know why the apple? You know what their symbol? You know what that is? When you check apple, you know what their symbol is? They give you apple beaten. That's their symbol. They show apple a chunk. They say they want to bite, just like Eve. Bite apple. Because they claim apple was what Eve ate and became wise. So they want a chunk of the same apple. They have all kinds of things going on out there that, you know, but that's why we are in this world, but not of this world.
Amen.
You have to know who you are. Amen. Amen. And I don't want to talk much about the lifestyle of some of those people and what they believe. And some are even atheists.
Mm.
And they believe and they are atheists. They have Christian scientists, Scientologists, that many, many great Americans belong to. They are idol worshiping.
Amen.
Hallelujah. See now, as then let's continue on 2:14. The hold of this religion was remarkable. Its formidable power did not lie extended to the realm of Misery, but lay the fact that no one could belong to this cult. So prophet is talking about 2:14. In the age of Thyatira, no one could have commerce, no one can do anything unless you worship Apollo. And that's what Jezebel did in Israel. That's why it's a type of the spirit of Jezebel. Because remember, Jezebel have her own, and if you don't worship him, you're dead. That's why it took Elijah
Amen. On
the scene
Amen.
To challenge that spirit.
Amen.
And today, Elijah is on the scene.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We are Elijahs. You know that? We are. We have the same spirit.
Amen.
We have the same spirit
Amen.
To rebuke evil. That's the spirit. Hallelujah. If you don't have that spirit, you can see these things. We have the same anointing today. Because if there is evil, there has to be good.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
Two of them must be there. The prophet said that every revival produces a twin.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You go all the way to the book of Genesis. There were twins there. Cain and Abel.
Amen.
There were twins. Cain had to kill Abel. Hallelujah. They were twins when Isaac bare a child. They were Jacob, they were Esau, twin. Every revival produced twin. When Jesus came, they were twin. Because they were the seller of Jesus, the evil spirit, and they were Jesus, the Holy Ghost, standing there. And there was one that had to sell him. Hallelujah. That's Judas Iscariot. That's a twin right there. Every revival would produce a twin. Hallelujah. So in this church age, it's a twin. You either worship Apollo or you're dead. Hallelujah. That's what the prophet is saying. And the spirit of Thyati'ra, which you know, stands for a dominating female. Amen. The spirit of Thyati'ra stands for a dominating female. Amen. So again, mark that, because when you have a dominating female spirit, it's not godly. It's not the intention of God. God is not saying that your husband cannot love you as a wife, but God is saying do not dominate your husband. You work together as a team, but don't dominate. Hallelujah. We can get to the book of Ephesians when Apostle Paul was preaching on a true marriage. Because what we are talking about here is a marriage also. Because remember that Jesus came to marry. Apostle Paul was ministering on marriage. He said, but I speak concerning the church and Christ. Mm-hmm. Because Christ is the husband of the church. Amen. That's why the church is the bride.
Amen.
And the bride is a type of a marriage. Mm-hmm. You cannot be a bride without a bridegroom.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In a true marriage, everything works out just fine. Because there's love in that marriage. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But Jezebel didn't come to love Ahab. She came to dominate.
Amen.
That's why when Elijah went with the prophet of Baal, 400 of them, he challenged them. And he said, if Baal be Baal, worship him.
Amen.
If God be God of Abraham, let's worship him.
Amen.
Bring your sacrifice.
Amen.
Pray for your God to consume it. And they prayed all they want. And nothing could happen.
Amen.
And Elijah began to mock them. Maybe Baal went to lunch. Maybe Baal is in the bathroom somewhere. Keep calling him. Maybe he's sleeping. Maybe if wake him up. They were calling Elijah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He did the right thing.
Amen.
Before he could call God and answer by fire, he made the altar right. He took 12 stones. He built 12 stones on top of each other, representing the 12 sons of Jacob. Hallelujah. And when he finished there, he placed the sacrifice. You see now, as a Christian, you have to do the right thing. You have to put the altar right. You have to live a sanctified life. Then you watch God if God will not fulfill the desires of your heart. But first, you have to put the altar right.
Amen.
And then watch what he will do.
Right.
He will not fail you. Never will fail. So that's what this Jezebel is, a dominating spirit. She's a mystery Babylon. The prophet said, she's the great whore. Jezebel is a false prophetess, because the true female is submissive to God. The true female, which is the true church, is submissive to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Christ is the head.
Amen.
She has no word, no thought, no leadership. But what about this church? She has cast out the word. See, Jezebel as a church cast out the word. Doesn't need Jesus anymore. See, she has taken over the king. She controls the army. You know, she is now the leader. That's why when Elijah came back, and then Ahab told Jezebel, hey, look what this man of God did. He called fire. Ahab had great testimony. And Jezebel said, oh, is that right? Okay. As her own God liveth, she said, I will not see this man alive. And he sent to make sure that they kill Elijah. He was looking to kill Elijah. That's why you talk about the man Canaan experience. After Elijah was done, he started running for his life. You would think a man that called fire to come down, you're running away from this woman. But he was running away for his life. Hallelujah. But he never knew he cannot die. Nothing can happen to a child of God except God says so. Hallelujah. The messenger for this church age is Columba. Time is fast against us. But Columba is the messenger for this church age. And there are so many testimonies the prophet gave about Columba. I'm on line 218 if you want to follow through. The testimonies of Columba, one of the testimonies the prophet said on 218 was, Columba was going to a missionary. He said when he got to there, You know, the gate was closed and barren. They didn't want him to preach. They closed the gate of this place. So when they closed the gate of the place, they were making mockery of him. They were making so much noise so nobody can hear him from outside the gate. And Columba began to sing psalms. He got to sing psalms like a song, the psalms of David. When he got to sing the psalm now, the prophet said, God magnified his voice. And it was so loud that the sound of his voice shook the whole place and opened the walls and opened everything, and he just walked through. Hallelujah. The sound of his preaching, the sound of his songs. Hallelujah. In another way, the prophet said again, he was going to minister, and you know, a little child died. Of course, he raised a little child. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So he selected as a church messenger because the prophet said his teaching, his doctrine were in alliance to the word of God. Not because he was the only one at the time that was anointed, because St. Patrick was also there at the time, the prophet said. As a matter of fact, if you listen to the church age book, the prophet talks so much about St. Patrick. But he says, St. Patrick is not the church age messenger for the church of Thyatira, but it's Columba. He mentioned even the fact that how St. Patrick's life was, how, you know, he was like a slave somewhere, and he was so good at raising dog or something, and then he was raising the dog of the master. He has many dogs, and he can command the dog to do stuff. And one day, the voice of God spoke to him, and he wanted to do something for God, but he didn't know how to go. So, you know, they said that the boat was leaving at the time. There was a boat that the man was selling a lot of dog. And then he made a sign, and he entered the boat and made a sign. The dog came and covered him and began to make some noise on the boat. And then had to command the sailor to drop him off on the shore, where he now began his ministry. Amen. And then the prophet talked about the fact that we don't go into so many, you know, argument and stuff like that, but the truth be told, and the history is there, because the prophet said St. Patrick has nothing to do with Roman Catholic. And they're claiming him to be a Catholic, but he was never one. But, you know, history proves itself. Hallelujah. For us, we just want to be believers that took the word of God. We took all the history. We took whatever is there. We want to make sure we are better Christians. Amen. Because the race we are running is personal. The race that Brother Abraham run is good for him.
Amen.
If I don't run the race, I will get nothing. Amen. The same thing with you. Amen. So the word is given to us to eat the word. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, and then the prophet talked about, you know, what, you know, in the days of Pope, and you can look at Church Age Message like 240, you know, how the Pope and the Muslim rose at the same time, you know, denouncing Christianity. He said it was in this age that we witnessed the rise of Mohammedanism, which is Muslim, that denied the Son of God, because the main doctrine of Muslim, they said that Jesus Christ is not the Son of God. That's the main doctrine. They believe that Jesus Christ is a prophet. They are calling him a prophet. It's in their Quran. They just say they don't believe they are anything like the Son of God. You see now? So if you don't receive Jesus Christ in the true sonship that he came to us, you also will be in error.
Amen.
You see now?
Yeah.
In the true sonship. Because there are many sons.
Right.
He came in different sonships.
Amen.
Son of man, Son of God, and soon to be Son of David in millennium. That's why when the woman saw him and asked him, woman of Samaria, asked him, Son of David, have mercy on me. Jesus didn't answer her a word. Because Jesus didn't come as Son of David in the first coming.
Amen.
He came as Son of Man.
Amen.
His first coming was Son of Man.
Amen.
He said it in the scripture. He said that birds, they have nets. He said that foxes, they have holes. But the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. And Son of Man means the office of a prophet.
Amen.
You go read the book of Ezekiel, God calls him Son of Man.
Yes.
I dwelt on the book of Ezekiel and Daniel all the week. It was such a book. Because you see how God will call a man like Ezekiel and tell him how to lie down for about 300-something days. Lie on this side for the sin of your people. Lie on this side for the sin of your people. Don't move. And he told him, if you don't tell them, their sin will be upon you. You must go tell them as I told you. And then you get into Lamentations of Daniel. Lamentations of Jeremiah. See, the word of God will sound so good, but when it enters inside you, it must do something in your life. Despite the calling of Jeremiah, the people didn't want to listen to him. And God is telling him, I will punish these people. I will send Nebuchadnezzar. They didn't want to listen. Until Babylon came and took away everything that Judah has. And today, God is warning us for these church ages. So the church messenger has been established. The history of Pope and Muslim, you know them. There's eulogy here that God put in 219. Revelation 219, I'm going to end in 10 minutes. Revelation 219 is the eulogy. The eulogy is about the passion they had. And the prophet said, here we find the same introductory mark. I know your works. The Son of God himself said it. Remember, when did Jesus become the Son of God? When he came down to indwell in us. Understand that. Son of man, they have to kill him. Because he said, you will kill me like you kill other prophets before me. Is that right?
Amen.
He also said the same way that Moses in the wilderness rose this brazen serpent.
Amen.
That anyone that looks on that serpent will be saved.
Amen.
From serpent, he said. And Moses said, so shall the Son of Man be raised up. He said, I am the one Moses is talking about.
Amen.
That's why they have to put him on a stick.
Amen.
That's why they have to crucify him.
Amen.
To fulfill the scripture. That's why that John had to wash him. He was a lamb for Passover. John said, no, I can't baptize you. You baptize me. He said, no, John, we have to fulfill all righteousness.
Amen.
You must wash this lamb. Because this is a lamb for sacrifice.
Amen.
Lamb without blemish. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the first coming of Jesus, he was on earth as Son of Man.
Amen.
But then he said, I am coming again. He came back as Son of God.
Amen.
Son of God is the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
To indwell in man.
Amen.
You cannot kill him. You cannot touch him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But as Son of Man, they spit on his face. They can slap him around. They ask him, tell us who slapped you. We talked about that last Sunday when he said nothing no more. There was a time he said nothing. He was here as Son of Man. And in millennium, he's coming back.
Amen.
As Son of David.
Amen.
Then he will reign as a king. Amen. His first coming was not a king. You can't kill a king.
Amen.
He came as a lamb. That's why they killed him.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
And if you read the book of Malachi chapter 4, verse 5, it's clear in Malachi chapter 4, 5, where he said there, he said, I will send Elijah, the prophet, before what?
Yes.
Can you bring your son? Malachi 4, 5, real quick. We round it up. I have so many things here, but I'm not going to keep it too long. Malachi 4, 5 here. You say, behold, I will send you Elijah, the prophet, before the coming of the great. That's why they killed him. But the dreadful day of the Lord is the day of the Lord. That's what John saw. In Revelation chapter 1, John was in the spirit in the day of the Lord.
Amen.
That's why Peter also talked about the day of the Lord.
Amen.
Because the day of the Lord is the day of punishment.
Amen.
The day of the Lord is the day he will come to punish this world.
Yes.
Today is the day of man.
Yes.
Today is the day of man. That's why you can do whatever you want to do.
Yes.
Nation can do anybody. America can do whatever anybody. Russia, whatever. Somebody can walk into the church and take a gun and kill 26 people. It's the day of man. Do whatever you want to do. Carry on. But the day of the Lord is coming.
Mm.
On that day, the tree will be running away. The mountain will be running away. No place to hide.
Yeah.
That's what the scripture is saying. But I will send you Elijah.
Amen.
Before that day.
Yes.
Elijah has come.
Amen.
That's why we're living at the end time.
Amen.
The scripture has been fulfilled.
Amen.
Whether we like it or not, the scripture has been fulfilled.
Amen.
Because the day of the Lord is coming.
Yeah.
Who can stand on that day?
Yeah.
But today, if you hear his voice, do not harden your heart.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The rebuke was on Jezebel, which we talked about, the woman Jezebel. So you can read these things in the church 8 book. There's a rebuke of Jezebel. Jezebel anointing upon the people brought idolism. Idolatry to the people. See, let me read a little bit there, just a quickie. He said, the first and very important thing that we learn about Jezebel, line 227, Church 8 book, is that she is not a daughter of Abraham, nor is she your induction into the tribe of Israel, as was that of Ruth, like we talked about. The Moabites said, no, sir. This woman was the daughter of Etibar, king of Sidon. 1 Kings 16:31 talks about it. Who was the priest of Asatar? He had gained the throne by murdering his predecessor, Phinehas. So, we see right away that she was the daughter of a murderer. This certainly reminds us of Cain also, like we said, produces two twins. And the way that she brought a part of Israel was not through the spiritual channel that God, for God was worshipped and the laws of Moses was acknowledged, but from the time of Ahab's marriage to Jezebel, idolatry progressed deadly fashion. It was when this woman became the priest in the temple that she erected Asherah, Venus, and Baal, the sun god, that Israel came to the crisis point of her life. Amen? May God have mercy. There's so much there. Time will not permit us, so we're going to leave some, and then you can listen to the message yourself. And the churches of Thyatira, what are you taking away from it? The spirit of Jezebel. But the Lord said something, I will restore. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm going to end up, I will restore. Joel chapter 1, verse 4. That which the palmer worms have left, had the locusts eaten. That which the locusts have left, had the canker worms eaten. That which the canker worms have left, the caterpillar have finished it. And I told you caterpillar what it meant. The palmer worms ate the fruits, which is the Colossian deed, as a matter of fact. And the locusts, they ate the leaves, which is fellowship. The joy of your salvation is destroyed. That's the deceiver among us. Hallelujah. That's what the deceiver did. And you know, throughout the church age, he was regarded as the deceiver. Hallelujah. In the church age, was a deceiver. Is that right? It was a deceiver in the first church age. Hallelujah. When he was trying to deceive the church, that God was moving with the face of a lion. Hallelujah. The same deceiver came in the smaller church age when Irenaeus was there. Hallelujah. But he came to persecute the church. And the persecution continues from Irenaeus to Matthew to Columba, which is smaller Pergamos and Thyatira. And God was moving in this church age with the spirit of an ox. Hallelujah. Because that ox spirit was for sacrifice. Hallelujah. That was the time of Roman Inquisition. That was the time they were killing Christians like a bee. Hallelujah. They were smothering and killing them like nobody cares. But God kept silent. Why? Because it was the spirit that God used at that time. Hallelujah. But he said, I will restore. In John 2:23, he said, be glad then, ye children of Zion. Rejoice in the Lord your God, for he hath given you the former rain. Moderately, and he will cause to come down for you the rain, the former rain and the latter rain in the first month. Hallelujah. And the prophet told us that the former rain was used to plant the seed.
Yeah.
That was during the first church ages. Hallelujah. Yeah. It was a seed planting time. Hallelujah. They were moving like forces of lion. And when Ezekiel saw the chariot, Ezekiel said they were moving on the same direction. He said, I don't turn. Hallelujah. He said, they have four faces. Hallelujah. You have the lion. You have the ox. You have the man. You have the eagle. Hallelujah. I mean, Ezekiel said, they're moving the same direction because they can go either way without turning. The spirit of the Lord is that powerful. Hallelujah. What Ezekiel saw is what John saw. Hallelujah. In the book of Revelation. And God is telling us here that the former rain that started in the first church age continued in second and the third and the fourth and all the way to the final church age. Now we have the latter rain. The latter rain is for harvesting time. Hallelujah. Let's be on our feet. The latter rain is for harvesting time. This is a time of harvest. Hallelujah. Because the former rain come to plant the seed, to sow the word of God in the heart of man. Now the latter rain is to harvest what was sown. What is there since the first church age? We cannot bow down to Baal. We cannot worship idol. We cannot worship a man. We cannot worship organization. We can only worship the Lord our God. Hallelujah. He deserves the glory. He deserves to be praised. He said, I will restore glory. And on the day of Pentecost, Peter declared, it is that which was written in the book of Joel chapter 2. And on that day I will pour my spirit upon all flesh. And the old man will see dream. And the young man will see vision. Peter said, this is that day. We are still living on the same day. Because we have been restored. Hallelujah. The word of God has been restored. We know who Jesus Christ is. We are not second guessing him. No, he is not the third in person of Christ or God. He is the God. Because he was the God, the creator. As the creator, he made the heaven and the earth. As the son, he came to redeem man. Hallelujah. Amen. That was the plan of redemption. He had to take a body. Hallelujah. One day he came to visit Abraham. He also took a body. Hallelujah. He has taken bodies before. He was the great Melchizedek. And Abraham saw after he defeated the army. He was that Melchizedek without a father, without a son, without a mother, with their beginning and with their ending. Hallelujah. And that's what he declared to John. I am the one that live. I am the one that died. I am the one that will live to die no more. Hallelujah. It's all about him. Do you believe that this morning?
Amen.
Do you believe it's all about him? Say glory, hallelujah. It's all about Jesus Christ, hallelujah. He promised he will restore, and we are living to enjoy all that. And the floor shall be full of wheat, and the fire shall overflow with wine and oil, hallelujah. Remember wine and oil. God said, hot not the wine and oil. Do not hot my wine and oil. That's what he declared when they were going in the fourth church age. Do not hot the oil and the wine. Hallelujah. The oil and the wine, the oil is the Holy Ghost. The wine is the stimulation. Hallelujah. Are you stimulated this morning? And I will restore to you all the years that the locusts have eaten, the cankerworms have eaten, the pomeworms have eaten. I will restore my great army, which I will send among you. You shall eat in plenty. You will be satisfied and praise the name of your Lord. Oh, praise the name of our Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, blessed be the name of the living God. Hallelujah. You want to praise his name this afternoon?
Amen.
You want to praise his name this afternoon?
Amen.
You have to claim him to be yours.
Amen.
One day he was coming down. You will say, Brother Paul, that sounds strange. What I'm going to tell you is that I'm claiming what he said for me to claim.
Amen.
Because every promise in the scripture belongs to me.
Amen.
Does it belong to you?
Amen.
Now you claim it yourself. Now when you say our Lord's Prayer, you can say it this way. My Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. May I do your will on earth as it is done in heaven. Give me this day my daily bread. Forgive me my trespasses as I forgive those who have trespassed against me. Lead me not into temptation, but deliver me from evil. For thou art the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. You have to claim it to be your own.
Amen.
You have to own it.
Amen.
When you just say, our Father, who hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, who will do his will? Me. It's you. You have to say, I will do your will as it's done in heaven.
Amen.
It's not let us do your will. Who is the us? It's me. I will do it. You will do it.
Amen.
When the voice of God said, who shall I send? You say, I am here. Send me. Reveal yourself unto me. Show me, Lord.
Amen.
Show me in the secret of your heart, in the secret of your place. Show me that you belong to me, Lord.
Amen.
You have to want it yourself.
Amen.
It's not a group out there. Nobody will give it to you but you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You alone will stand before the King of Glory one day to account for your life. Nobody else can do it for you. Your own testimony, your own life, hallelujah. That's what the scripture says here. We just read it. Your walk, hallelujah. I will judge you by what you have done. Not what somebody else have done. What have you done with what I gave you? What did you do with the power and the anointing and the oil I poured upon you? What did you do? You have excuses. This person did that. This person. God doesn't want to hear that. God is asking me. Asking you. Remember, we are Gentiles. Gentiles are called individually. There's no Gentile nation that was called by God. So when you do that this morning.
Amen.
Let's go into prayer. Then we'll sing a few songs. I feel like praying before the songs. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the living God. Blessed be his holy name. Let's pray together like we always do. Pray for what you need. Thank God for what he's done for you the previous week and your life. And ask God to continue the rest of the journey. Because the journey is far. But he's there to feed us like he fed Elijah. So ask him to feed you. Remember your family, your loved ones. Claim every promise belongs to you. Healing belongs to you. Healing is his wings. It's to give his children. Every promise in the scripture belongs to you. You have to be personal. You have to claim it. Holy Ghost is personal. Hallelujah. When Cornelius was praying, it was personal. The scripture said that Cornelius has found favor before the Lord. It wasn't a group. It was a person. Jesus is a person. He's personal to the believers. A believer is a person. He's a human being that accepted Jesus as his Lord and Savior and have sold out to this world just to follow him. He said, Lord, where you lead me, I will follow. Ruth was a person that decided to follow Naomi, but Orpah could not follow. You see now, two of them were both in-laws, but Ruth and Orpah were in-laws, but Orpah could not follow. It was personal to Ruth because the kinsman redeemer was waiting for a seed to redeem, because God has predestinated her. She has to make a trip back to Israel because Boaz was waiting, hallelujah, a type of a kinsman redeemer. Ruth was there walking to be seen by the redeemer, and we walked in the field. We walked in the field. We were called in the world of sin, and when he called our name, we answered. We said, Lord, here I am. Here I am, Lord. Just like Mary. Let it be done to me, Lord, according to your word. My Lord, my God, my heavenly Father, everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, I am that I am. Blessed be the name of Jesus. It's all about Jesus Christ. That I live or die is Jesus Christ. That I rise every day is Jesus Christ. That I have joy unstoppable is Jesus Christ. That I have brothers and sisters is Jesus Christ. That I can testify in the land of living is Jesus Christ. That I can magnify the name is Jesus Christ. Oh, hallelujah. There will be a rapture is Jesus Christ. There will be a millennium is Jesus Christ. Oh, living he loved me. Oh, dying he saved me. Oh, buried he carried my sin far away. Oh, rising he justified me. One day he's coming again. What a glorious day that will be. My Lord, my God, I thank you this day. My heart is filled with joy because I am among those that call believers. I am among those that worship you. And we want to worship you every day of our life. We want to send glory to your life, Lord Jesus. My brothers and sisters are here, Lord. They need you, Lord Jesus. You will finish what you have started in their life. Each and every one of them, their life will testify to the goodness of the Lord. In the land of the living, everything we touch will be a blessing because he says so. Our life will be a blessing because he says so. Our thought will be a blessing because he says so. Everything we touch will be a blessing. Our family will be a blessing because he says so. Everything we go will be a blessing. Our action will be a blessing because he says so. Our body will worship the Lord because he asks us to do just that. Our mind will worship the Lord because he wants us to do just that. Let every living thing glorify God. Let every living organism glorify God. Glorify God in the firmament of his beauty. Glorify God in the firmament of his house. I lift up my head, said to David. I lift up my head to the hills and the mountains. From whence will come my salvation? My salvation will come from the God of Abraham, from the God of Isaac, from the God of Jacob. He never slumber. Jesus Christ is his name. He came down as a flesh. But great is the mystery of godliness. And without controversy, that God was manifested in flesh. Oh, hallelujah. For sinners like us, you come down, you condescended. You took our place that we can take your place. You were nailed at Calvary. You were sin that's already judged. You took our sin upon yourself. And it was judged at Calvary. And now we can stand the test of time. But when you came to Nebuchadnezzar, you told him, your kingdom is found wanting because you don't have something that I have. But we can say hallelujah. We are not found wanting no more because we have been fulfilled. We have been blessed. We have been washed by the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. He declared in Calvary, it is finished. And he said, whom the Son of God set free, he is free indeed. We are free. Hallelujah. Declare the counsel of God. Declare the interminable of counsel of God. Go to the mountaintop and shout, Jesus Christ has risen. Shout that Jesus is risen in your heart. Let Jesus be risen in your life. Let Jesus manifest in my life. Hallelujah. 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 Glory. Honor. Hosanna. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Blessed be the name of the living God. We give you glory. We give you glory. I thank thee, O Lord, for Brother Sylvester and family, Lord. Thank you for great work you did in their life. You will finish what you started. I thank you, O Lord, for my precious brother Christopher Knight. Thank you for the life he's living. Thank you for his mother-in-law. I know she was sick. Ah, Lord Jesus, thou knowest everything. Ah, is there anything impossible for you to do? Get glory out of the life of his mother-in-law. Oh, we thank thee, O Lord, for the life of his mother. The life of his mother testify that Jesus Christ is still healing. There is still power in Gilead. Hallelujah! He still created another kidney for the mother of Chris Bernard. She's a living testimony that Jesus Christ is alive. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Hallelujah! Blessed be the name of the living God. Oh, glory, hallelujah! I thank thee, O Lord, for my precious brother Gessner. Hallelujah! Oh, devil, you are defeated in the life of my brother.
Amen.
Devil, you have no hand in the life of my brother.
Amen.
Devil, my brother will stand the test of time. Devil, you come to him like a flood. But my God, I believe a standard against you. For my brother said that he can stand the test of time, that he can manifest Jesus in the land of the living. But I guess now we give you your family. We give you your family in the land of the living. Your family will obey your word. Your wife will come and plead. Hallelujah. Because Jesus Christ is the same. You deserve the best if you are living the life of Christ. Let the life of Christ be you, my brother. Go and testify that Jesus has healed you. Testify that you have been made whole. He has restored, saith the Lord. He said, I will restore all the years of the worms I've eaten. Hallelujah. My mother is blessed in the name of Jesus. Oh, remain blessed, my mother. Remain blessed, all that came from your womb. Hallelujah. But a Sylvester, hallelujah, your mother-in-law is blessed. In the name of Jesus Christ, every place the saints we gather today, oh, from New York to Georgia, to West Orange, to Ghana, to Nigeria, to India, every place the saints are gathering, we join our faith together in one accord. We send this prayer to heaven. Let it come to God as a sweet smelling savor. Let it go straight to God. Let the evil never hold this prayer. Oh, like the angel Gabriel told Daniel. He said, Daniel, your prayer was answered even before your supplication. Your prayer was answered. But the king of Persia, they were holding me there. But they cannot hold this prayer. They cannot hold this prayer. This is anointed in the sight of my living God. Oh, this prayer is anointed with the blood of Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Our prayer together is coming to God like a sweet smelling savor as we bind our faith together. And the scripture tells us anything we bind on earth is bound in heaven. Anything we lose on earth is losing heaven. And then we come together in one accord, as it was on the day of Pentecost, to have the same experience, to have the same experience, to have the same testimony. And on the day of Pentecost, the Holy Ghost came down. Hallelujah! Let the Holy Ghost come down and bind our faith where we can disbelieve his word. No more. We ask with thanksgiving. The precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are
heirs
of the Father. We are joined heirs with the Son. We are people of his kingdom. We are family. We are one. We are washed. We are sanctified.
As we sing our last song, sing that song again. Think about his love, brother Paul, let's sing that song. Think about his love. Think about his goodness. Think about his grace that brought us through. For as high as the heavens above, so great is the measure of our Father's love. Great is the measure of our Father's love. Sing it one more time. Think about his love. Think about his goodness. Think about his grace that brought us through. For as high as the heaven above, so great is the measure of our Father's love. Great is the measure of our Father's love. Amen. Father, we pray that you would go before us as we go our various ways. And as we're about to have some fellowship in the back, may you bless our fellowship, Lord. Bless the food. Whatever we're going to do, may it bring glory to your name. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Think about his love. About his good.